We present an implicit physical face model driven by expression and style, learned from real captured data. Facial animation with blend shapes is a common practice because of its simplicity and intuitive nature. However, its limitations are evident in real-world applications. For instance, in the context of retargeting, it suffers from some artifacts like lip penetration, which often takes a lot of time to correct. This can be seen here on a cutaway of the mouth region from a recent facial retargeting method by Chandran and his colleagues. In addition, for the semantically same expressions, different identities have their own muscle actuation styles. This is always baked into his own unique blend shape basis, unable to be added by the artist. Our solution leverages a physics-based simulation that considers underlying anatomical features. This naturally bypasses these issues, offering a more realistic approach to facial animation and increased artistic control. Recently, Yang et al. Introduced an implicit physical face model driven by expression inputs. However, this model, designed for a single identity, overlooks an important aspect of human expression, individual style. Building a separate network for each identity ignores the fact that individuals share many common muscle structures, and a true model that captures the personality would be able to learn from such regularities. Inspired by this, we extended the network design from Yang et al. To allow training on performance data from multiple identities at once, learning cross-identity physical correlations. In doing this, however, we are faced with three main challenges. Firstly, each individual face is unique. They differ in shape. Naively learning actuations in different material spaces will make it hard for the network to learn or identify meaningful muscle structures that can be shared across identities. Secondly, each person has unique ways of making expressions, thus requiring customized actuation fields and gel movements. We call these unique characteristics of a person their style in our work. And thirdly, instead of resorting to narrow-to-near collision-free results, we want to synthesize identity-specific collision response robustly. To solve the first challenge, we introduce a canonical material space for training, and we compute a spatial mapping from each identity space to the canonical space. For the second challenge, we obtain personalized actuation fields and gel movements by introducing a known style code, in addition to a given expression code. These codes are used to obtain the physical constraints in the canonical space, which are finally walked back to the identity-specific space before simulation. Finally, we incorporate a robust contact model into our simulation framework, allowing us to synthesize identity-specific collision response. This leads to our final network architecture. Our framework can support various applications. One of them is the retargeting. In our framework, this can be achieved by injecting the target identity style code and source expression blend weights, yielding the final retargeting result. Here is a result of retargeting in this way. On the right, we illustrate the actuation tensor predicted by the network and show a cutaway of the mouth region to highlight the collision handling. Here, we play the video again but show the full anatomy on the right. Note that, in our retargeting scenario, the source identity doesn't need to be seen during training. The zoning expression blend weights are required to do the retargeting, as we show here. However, if the source performance is available at training time, we believe that including it in the training data will allow the network to generalize that performance to new identities and provide even better retargeting results. Our framework can support style transfer, as we can use the source identity style code to animate a character. Here is the result of style transfer in this way. On the right, we show the animation results with the identity's original style. It can be seen that the source style is naturally injected into the target. Here is another result of style transfer in this way. Thanks to our canonical space, the network learns meaningful muscle structures that are transferable across identities. Due to our Lipschitz regularization, we can also linearly blend two style codes and use the interpolated style code to animate the character. Here is the result of style interpolation in this way. The middle section displays results achieved at varying interpolation ratios. Note how the actuation patterns are smoothly interpolated. As a physics-based model, it can support various physical effects. Our versatile collision model can be used to synthesize friction effects during inference time. When we don't account for friction in our model, the lower lip slips inside the upper lip and it then suddenly pops out. It is not very natural, but when we include this effect in our model, the movement of the lower lip becomes much more consistent with the upper lip. This friction effect brings a lot of more realism into our simulation. Secondly, our model has the ability to simulate facial paralysis easily. The paralyzed section isn't completely rigid. It naturally deforms in response to movements from other parts of the face. For instance, if we look at the full anatomy on the left, we can see how the mandible movement influences the deformation of the paralyzed section. Finally, our model provides us with the capability to change the shape of the mandible. Any changes made to the shape of the mandible are then naturally propagated to the skin of the face. We now show the ablation study on the architectural design and comparisons to recent work. We start with an ablation study to justify our network design choices. Here we show the result of four different variants of the network. We visualize the input blend width using the current identities blend basis, as demonstrated in the second column. For the first variant, actuation is done directly in different material spaces. This approach leads to the production of many artifacts. In the second variant, the network learns the actuation in the canonical space without warp operation, generalizing better than the first one. The third variant predicts the actuation in canonical space and then warps them. Finally, we show that adding Lipschitz regularization provides smoother, more natural phase motion. Our work is inspired by the recent single identity model of Young et al. However, we made several changes. First, we replaced all the siren layers except the first with Galu, since we found siren prone to noise and sensitive to initialization. Second, we used tunnel activation function to constrain the modulation codes. This can help remove most of the artifacts. Finally, our multi-identity model produces even better animation results. Now, we showcase the impacts of our collision model. Remarkably, it's capable of generating natural collision effects, thereby enhancing the animation realism. Here, we compare to the recent retargeting method of Chandra and his colleagues. Our method produces comparable overall retargeting quality while being more physically accurate and preventing lip intersections. One benefit of our approach is that we can train on multiple identities at once, allowing the network to learn from cross-identity data. Here we see the single identity network trained on data only from the target character compared to our method trained on multiple identities. Clearly, the ability to leverage multi-identity data allows our method to produce superior retargeting results. Here we compare to the displacement variant. It throws away the physics completely and learns the displacement field directly. The displacement variant not only struggles with issues of penetration, but also with sudden volume changes and shape distortions. These issues become especially pronounced around the mouth region. Our physics-based model produces much more stable and natural results. In summary, we propose an implicit physical face model driven by expression and style, which can support various applications like retargeting style transfer and can synthesize physical effects. Thanks for watching.